Welcome back to our brand new Alpine, guys. A few weeks ago, we showed you that we got the brand new Alpine as our new development and show car. As you can quite clearly see in the background, the car switched its color. Actually, the wrapping is done and we picked quite a special color because we thought for the Alpine, we need something which kind of catches the eye. So we wrapped it in Sandstorm Gloss Metallic, which is a brand new color and we quite like it. Also, the car already got lowered with Eibach springs. And most importantly, the run-in period is done, so we were able to drive the car full throttle and stock, and most importantly, we are now able to start our product development shortly. But first of all, we want to show you how the car behaves in stock on a dyno, how the values are, how much performance it brings in stock conditions. And maybe Danny, you can tell us a little bit about the chart.
Actually, we started the development already a couple of days ago because the process is a little bit longer. But the car put down in stock 160 horsepower, so a little bit more than actually claimed, but still in zero tolerances. And the 328 newton meters of torque, which is a little bit more than the official figure, which is 320, but still totally fine. Of course, during the development process, we are logging a lot of different values out of the ECU or out of the engine, like lambda, air to fuel for the American or US guys, ignition time, and of course the boost pressure and a lot of more different values. In terms of boost pressure, the car is running with 1.9 bar around that area, and it's holding the boost until red line, which is really, really cool. You can see it basically on the chart that the torque doesn't drop, which is really, really awesome. In terms of lambda, it's running a little bit rich with 0.75. We're gonna translate it to air to fuel ratio here somewhere. That's basically it when it comes down to the engine. 1.8 TCI engine or TCE engine, which is already known out of the Megane RS basically.
Exactly.
It's out of the same engine family.
And also what you mentioned, that it like holds the boost until red line, you can see it on the chart of course, but you can also notice it on the road. It's like it behaves a little bit in the lower RPM area, it's a little bit like a turbo engine like you're used to, but in the higher RPM you're almost thinking it's like a naturally aspirated engine, but a much bigger one. So if you think about it, it's a 1.8 liter and it really performs quite good, which we noticed a few days ago when we were able to do the autobahn measurements, 100 to 200 kilometers per hour. Actually, the car is quite fast in stock, you wouldn't think it maybe. So we're gonna show them to you now. So as you could see, the car was able in stock to get a 12.8, which for a 250 horsepower car, or as we measured it, 260 horsepower to be completely honest, is still quite fast. And this, as we mentioned in our first video about the car, is basically all about the weight. I mean, it's a small 1.8 liter turbo engine. It's not that powerful for modern standards, but it just has an easy job accelerating the car. So yeah, I think that was basically it for this video, except for the fact that I think a lot of you guys always wanted to see the engine of the Alpine without any covers. So we're gonna show it to you now, and also Dani's gonna tell you a little bit about the engine specifics.
I think you can come a little bit closer with the camera to check out the engine. Inline 4 1.8 turbocharged engines, single charged of course, water intercooled, but most of the modern cars are water intercooled now. What is really cool, you can see now that the engine is actually before the axle, which means it's a real mid-engine, and real mid-engines are not that common anymore, I would say, and like really hard to find a real mid-engine car. Basically makes the car really, really special, I would say. And also you can pick up a lot of the engine sound, and especially the turbo whistles from the cabin, which makes a lot of fun and helps to transform the car into a sports car, I would say, and it does make a lot of fun.
So I think this was it for today. Next up, we're gonna develop our RaceChip GTS Black performance enhancement for the car. This will definitely take another few weeks because it just takes a while to develop a proper product. So we'll get back to you as soon as the product's finished with performance numbers and of course 100 to 200 kilometers per hour times. And until then, stay tuned, subscribe to our channel to see our other videos about other cars. And of course, leave us a like if you liked the video, and see you in a few weeks.